basic principle behind that, you have to, out of all this religious concept, include that you are not, you are formless. You are unborn, it's fact. So body is a media. And as you know, body has a time limit. You are a child, then you become a young man, now old man, and some or other day willingly or unwillingly you have to leave the body. So it is fact, even if you think logically or intellectually, body is not identity at all. How you are prior to body and how you will after leaving the body, that indication, that reality, master placing before you and inviting attention of the invisible listener within you, that you are a Brahman, you are a master, you are everything, you are almighty God means ultimate truth, except you are selfless, if there is no God. So, in the beginning, till you get conviction, you have to have exercise, meditation, bhajan and all these things. Afterward, it will be spontaneous. Even though you are holding body, you remain unconcerned with the world. What is the world? When you come across the world, the moment that awakening is there, the moment that spirit click with the body, you see I. Then immediately with the experience of I, entire world is projected. Where was that world prior to beingness? After living, where is the world? That means entire world is illusion. Illusion is world disappears with illusions. To say I, it is illusion, to say you, illusion, to say Brahman, illusion. Entire world is illusion. So in illusionary world, whether you are realized or enlightened, it is meaningless. These are not, but for sake of understanding, we say you are realized, enlightened, you have a lot of knowledge, etc., etc. So, spiritual master also, that is illusionary words. But spiritual masters, placing before you the listener's importance, listener's presence, which is called Brahman. So, be with you all the time. Because, I am repeating, human body is a golden opportunity for you. Though it is not your identity, but through human body, you can identify yourself. Because presence, individual presence within the body is ultimate truth. So if you go on talking spirituality and the theory, practice, that is meaningless. Not to read any Veda, nothing to do. Because it indicates your unidentified entity, that you are. So, the glimpses of I within the body is called ultimate truth, through which you are experiencing I. Prior to I, your presence was there. After living, what your presence will be there. Prior to being there, your presence was there. So, in all the time, presence is not going in just like a space or sky. If you go in America, sky is same. If you go in China, sky is same. So, like that, the presence within the body is one and the same. There is no difference. And then, after conviction, Nama Mantra also illusion. Meditation also illusion. But Nama Mantra is required till you get spontaneous conviction. I am nothing to do with the body. Though I am holding body, I am totally different from the body. I am formless. A spontaneous experience, a spontaneous feeling supposed to be appear within you, for which you are doing all these things, meditation all. So bhajan is creating spiritual atmosphere within you, and meditation also one of the part through which you get conviction. So these are the various discipline, spiritual discipline you have to follow in the beginning only, till you go out of this illusionary concepts. This is a dream. Human life is a dream. When you see the dream, you see everything is reality. In dream, when you are in dream, you see everything is reality. After awakening, you say we are in a dream. Similarly, so far we are holding the body, we feel that everything is true. But after living body, what is the true and false? Nothing. Prior to beingness, nothing true, nothing false. So there is no I, there is no you, he, she, nothing is there. So everything came out of nothing, everything dissolved in nothing. Where you stand? What is your position in the world? You may be a great philosopher, you may be a great master, and you are a small person, you are not the same. What is not giving any so much effects. So try to understand, try to identify yourself. Who is listening from this body, who is experiencing from the body, who is watching dreams from the body, who is doing activities from this body. Like that you start self-inquiring. The self-inquiry leads to self-knowledge. Self-knowledge leads to self-realization. These are stages, just for understanding purpose. So, don't say I have to realize, I have to enlighten. These are the words. Realization, enlightenment, these are the words. As such, there is no such realization, enlightenment. These are the concept within the spiritual concept within the span of the body knowledge. But you have to do it very seriously. Don't neglect it. Not any wearing mind. There should not be temptation to go anywhere. Beyond this, nothing is there in the world. If you go on changing various masters, you visit so many temples, nothing is going to happen. It is a waste of time. You visit your own temple within you. God is within you. God is not separate from you. Master is not separate from you. Bodies are different. Presence is one and the same. Individual presence within your body is one and the same. You call Brahman, Atman, Paramatman, God, Master, that you are. What more you want? Nothing.
What is the aim of that? Because we are all here with the same longing, and some of people are not. So it's something to be in the future. I know it's
not. There is no future, no present, no past.
No future, but when you say prior to beingness,
just for understanding, I have to use some words. Don't analyze my words. What I want to convey that most important. Prior to beingness, after living body, these are the words through which I am trying to indicate it, except your self-presence, the thing is there. Your presence prior to beingness was there. After living body, your presence will be there. At present, presence is there.
It's not my presence.
So, you are talking literally, my presence, your presence, there is no my, you, he, she, nothing is there. How do you listen? So, there is no I, there is no you, there is my, nothing is there. Is body or yours? Your body is yours. To say my, to say I, some power is required, some energy is required.
Yes.
Have you got any individual identity that so to say I or say my? Nothing is there. Everything came out of nothing. So since you are holding body, you have got some ego that I am somebody else. Out of that somebody else, some questions are there. There is no my, I, he, she, nothing is there. There is no existence. You are considering your body form. You are formless. How you are prior to beingness? Either I is there, my is there, he, she, it is there, nothing is there. No God is there, no master is there. After living mode, what remains? Nothing. I don't know, correct that. When you say I don't know, that means I am not informed. When I give the example, when you are alone in the house, somebody knocked door, you say, nobody is there. When somebody is shouting from outside, anybody is there? You say, nobody is there.
Yeah,
that means you are there. So, that's why I say, when you say, I don't know, means your presence is there.
Yes, but I don't know, or nothing. Maybe it's nothing also.
Yes, nothing. You have everything come out of nothing. This is an illusionary world. In dream, you see so many things. What is true or what is false? After awakening, what is true thing, what is false thing in a dream? It is dream. Yes, this is also a dream. But you are treating dream as a real dream. There is no real, there is no unreal. No true, no false. Totally nothing.
Yes.
This illusion about everything is nothing. Nothing. These are illusion bodies. The concept. Therefore, I am insisting not to measure yourself in body form. Not to count yourself in body form. There is no body at all. Body is not identity. Body was not identity. Body is not going to remain identity. To say, some presence is required, power is required, energy is required. I am talking about that energy through which you are talking, I. If there is no energy in the body, how can I say, I, you, she, it, nothing? Dead body can't say I. Dead body again can't say my. Say I, mine, him. These are the words. not to play with the words. Spirituality also is illusion. Spirituality itself is illusion, but to illusion we have to remove another illusion. Therefore I mentioned that realization, enlightenment, these are the words. They are not such a realization, enlightenment. Where was the realization, enlightenment prior to beingness? Prior to beingness, do you know whether you realize or not? So these are what you, in human form. But through words you are trying to indicate, except yourself, nothing is there. We have created language, just to understand it, just to convince yourself. It is addressed to the invisible listener within you. The invisible presence within you, it is the ultimate truth. And for which you have to undergo strict meditation. Without meditation, it is not possible for you to identify yourself. Only literal knowledge, dry knowledge, or say, comparative knowledge, analytical knowledge, not meaningful.
Is it necessary to read scripture? Is it necessary?
You can read it, no problem. But while reading,
the right kind of scripture.
You can read, no problem. But while reading, just find out who is the reader. It is reader's information. And not to read some theoretical, which is insisting some karma, do this karma, do that karma. Because they are not doers, they are not deed. Some books are insisting Parayana. Try to know Narayana, not to see not to have Parayana. Only Parayana not the sole purpose. When people are insisting, do the Parayana of this Grantha, that Grantha. Why to Parayana? See the Narayana within you. You are keeping aside Narayana and doing Parayana, it is meaningless. The story of Narayana, not a Parayana. So you are itself Narayana. Narayana, ultimate truth. Great God. This is an analytical study. With the various words, placing before various words. Not to analyze, not try to define the words. Try to find out the listener. Who is listening from this? Body is not listening. If there is no presence within the body, who listens to the master? When you see master, seer is there. A seer is having most importance. The individual seer within is the master of masters. If there is no seer within the body, who knows what is the master, what is the disciple? Disciple, masters, God, deity, devotee, all these concepts. Appearing with a human form. We have created language, we are given the meaning of the every word. Not to analyze the words, not to be comparison to various masters. I am really telling you, why this master said like this, why the master said like this. What do you want out of that? Where you stand? What Ramana Maharshi said like this, what Nisargadatta Maharshi said like this. Not to make comparative study of all the masters. What they want to indicate is most important. The common message of the all masters that except yourself, there is no God, no Brahman, no Atman, no Paramatman. You are master, you are master, you are Brahman, you are ultimate truth. Don't count yourself in body form. Body form is not your reality. And therefore you are unborn, there is no birth and death. You are final truth.